Hey everybody, I am so excited that you are joining us again online today. Today we are entering a time of the year right before Christmas called Advent. I know that we are all so excited for Christmas Day, but the time of Advent is about waiting. Waiting until Christmas when we celebrate God coming to earth in Jesus. With everything going on in the world, Christmas has to look a little different this year. One would say that we want to build Christmas. So in your boxes, you'll see pictures of Lego bricks on all the papers you got. The hope is that this year, in a year unlike any other, we'll be able to build new Christmas experiences. It will take a lot of creativity, but if I've learned anything about you at home, is I know that you have all the creativity you need. Our song of the month is about to play, so I want to encourage you to grab the construction paper and the Lego bricks from your box so you'll be ready for our activity in a moment.
It just doesn't feel like Christmas at all. It's so hard to forget about all that went on. Some friends lost their jobs and some family too. And some people say it was all down to you. But I know Emmanuel, you're one of us. You left your throne to wear.
Time after all, the carols are soaring, the fire's roaring on. This year's had its trials, but sweet mercies too. Glad tidings of joy and hope down to you.
But I know Emmanuel, you're one of us. You left your throne to wear our scars. Though Christmas lights may lose their spark and winter's cold may break our hearts, oh, Christmas means Emmanuel, you're one of us.
So sister and brother, kind to each other. We've all had a journey, our own path to wander. The light will come, just know you're not alone.
So sister and brother, be kind to each other. We've all had a journey, our own path to wander. The light will come, just know you're not.
Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Nick, and this is Tanner. We are so glad you are joining us today. Who's excited for Christmas?
I am. I love Christmas time. There's so much good food, presents, and time with family and friends.
That's so true, Tanner. But do you know that the most important part of Christmas is?
That's a good question, Nick, and I do know. The reason we celebrate Christmas is to celebrate Jesus coming down to earth as a baby to save us.
Exactly, but back to the presents. How many kids are hoping to get some Lego for Christmas? How many of you have already received Lego for past Christmases? Anyone?
I have. Always loved getting Lego for Christmas.
Lego is always a hot item at Christmas time, and this is a favorite for boys and girls. Lego lets you create, build, and imagine anything you can dream up. You can follow the directions to make the Millennium Falcon, or a fire truck, or a submarine. Or you can freestyle it, building whatever your imagination can think of, from a giant robot to a monster truck to a totally cool spaceship.
There's no limit to what you can build with Lego. This month, we're going to use Lego to create an amazing journey to Christmas this year. Each week, we're going to be building something special that reminds us of Christmas, and when we do, we're going to use our Lego creations to remind us of what the true meaning of Christmas really is.
Our journey to Christmas begins with the most popular of all Christmas symbols, the Christmas tree. Nothing gets you in the mood for decking the halls, Christmas cookies, and jingle bells quite like the warm glow of a well-lit, heavily decorated Christmas tree. Christmas trees with their evergreen branches remind us that Christmas is about new life. Their lights remind us of the Star of Bethlehem that led the wise men to Jesus and the light that came into the world that first Christmas.
Christmas trees can remind us of something else as well. They can remind us of the tree that Jesus encountered many years later at Easter time. Jesus came to earth with one purpose, to be our Savior. Jesus completed the mission spoken of by the prophet Isaiah, not on a Christmas tree, but on an old, rugged wooden cross.
The best time of year here in Lego City.
I know, it's Christmas time, and I am so excited.
A big Christmas time in my favorite time of year.
We've got to deck the halls with Legos that are jolly.
We're going to need a lot of red, and a lot of green, and a little bit of white.
Oh, and how about some winter animals like these?
Barefoot, we need trees.
Nothing says Christmas like a Lego Christmas tree.
Ooh, with snow and decorations.
But what the building?
Hey, what's that? It's a tree.
Doesn't look like a Christmas tree to me.
Yeah.
Looks more like a lowercase t.
It is not a lowercase t, it's a cross.
A cross? You're silly, this is Christmas, not Easter.
What better time to remember the tree where God gave us the greatest present we could ever receive?
What do you mean?
Well, what do you guys think of when you see a Christmas tree?
Decorations?
White?
Okay, but what else?
The ugly Mr. Potato Head ornament, but it's so ugly that I hid it on the back of the Christmas tree.
Okay, let me try this another way. What do you put under the tree?
Present?
You're right. Presents. At Christmas, we celebrate the greatest gift that God gave us. Jesus was born at Christmas. The real gift happened on the cross, when Jesus died on the cross for our sins.
You're right. Jesus died on the cross so he could forgive our sins.
That a bucket effort.
Better than an ugly Mr. Potato Head ornament.
Christmas trees with lights and decorations are beautiful at this time of year. But for me, there's no tree that represents Christmas like the one that Jesus died on.
It's a lovely tree too. I'm so glad God sent Jesus.
I would eat it.
Merry Christmas!
Let's read some verses in Isaiah to learn more about what Christmas is truly about. In Isaiah 9 verse 2, we read, The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deeper darkness, a light has dawned. And then again in verses 6 and 7, we read, "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from the time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this."
Isaiah sounds like he's talking about the Christmas season in the first verse. The people in darkness have seen a great light. Christmas trees give us a lot of light during the long, dark days of winter. But Isaiah wasn't talking about the lights of a Christmas tree. He was talking about the light of Jesus. Jesus knew there was only one way to forgive us for all of the wrong choices we make. He had to take our place and pay the price of our sins himself. Jesus did that when he allowed himself to be nailed to another tree, a cross of wood, where he died for us. Jesus loved us so much that he gave up his life to give us new life. That is why Jesus came and why we celebrate his birth at Christmas.
It's easy to lose sight of the meaning of Christmas. Christmas is a busy season. We're constantly running around and shopping, going to Christmas programs, enjoying Christmas parties, and participating in all the festivities. But this year, we have a unique opportunity, a new opportunity to experience Christmas in a different way. Isaiah wrote about the wonder of Christmas centuries before Jesus was even born. But even though Isaiah told everyone what was to come, no one was waiting for it. Jesus was born in a smelly stable, a humble birth for the King of Kings. There was no one to witness the gift of God that first Christmas except for a few shepherds, and they needed an angel to tell them what was going on.
This Christmas, I want to challenge you to remember the gift of Jesus every day. It is easy to think about the gifts that will end up under our Christmas trees, but we have received a much, much greater gift than those. Remember that God loved us so much, he sent his only son, Jesus. Remember that this was no spur of the moment plan either. God was planning the coming of Christ many centuries before he was born. Remember that Jesus wasn't only born on Christmas, but that he died on Easter to give us new life.
I hope you enjoy the Christmas trees you see this season. But whenever you see a Christmas tree this season, I want to challenge you to see a different tree. Let those beautiful Christmas trees remind you of the forgiveness that comes from the cross. May Christmas trees remind us of the gift Jesus gave us when he died for our sins. Let's remember what Christmas is really about, God fulfilling his promise to send a Savior.
Our memory verse today is Matthew 2, verse 10. It says, "When they saw the star, they were filled with joy."
That's a good verse. Let's say it again before we start with actions. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy.
That's awesome. Let's try and add some actions now. I think when they saw, we can go like this, pointing off into the distance.
Well, that makes sense.
Yeah.
And then we can do like just a star, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I like that. And then we could add for they were filled with joy, you can go like filling up and then smile at them, like filled with joy. You like that, Nick?
Yeah, that seems good.
All right, let's go. All right, let's try it. Let's try it with actions now. All right. Ready?
Yeah.
All right.
When they saw the star, they were filled with joy.
That was great.
That was actually really good. Should we do it once more for good measure?
Yeah, one more time. All right.
When they saw the star, they were filled with joy.
Awesome. Let's do one more time just for good measure.
Okay, last All time. Right. Here we go.
When they saw the star, they were filled with joy.
Awesome. Good job, guys.
Are you ready for an activity? Today, we're going to build Christmas trees out of Lego. If you don't have Lego, you can make a Christmas tree out of green paper. Get a parent to help you cut out the shape of a tree, and then you can add decorations using pencil, crayons, or markers. If you have Lego, you can use Lego instead.
Put your Lego tree or drawing in a place where you will see it often. Every time you see it, think of the gift that we received, Jesus.
Before we go, let's take a few moments to pray together and thank God for sending his son. I encourage you to say the words after me. Dear God, thank you for sending Jesus.
Dear God, thank you for sending Jesus.
Help me to be patient in waiting for Christmas Day.
Help me to be patient in waiting for Christmas Day.
Help me not forget the best Christmas gift we've received.
Help me not to forget the best Christmas gift we've received.
In Jesus' name, amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Friends, I want to say it again. Get creative in how you celebrate Christmas this year. In your box, we've included a group of devotions that you can do with your family. I'm confident that with a little effort and a lot of creativity, we can all make this the best Christmas season ever. Don't forget to send me the number of points you earned this week. If you've been collecting your points, you can now use them to purchase some gifts through the World Vision store. You can buy things like food and animals and sports equipment and school books for people in need in faraway countries. So have a parent email or text me what you would like to spend your points on, and Soul Sanctuary will do that on your behalf. We hope you have an awesome week, and don't forget to join us on Zoom for Soul Kids Online. We'll be doing this as long as we are not able to gather in person. I hope you have an awesome week, and we will see